Hello everyone, welcome to the Natatorium here at the Olympic Sports Centre in Nanjing. It's the last diving event of the Youth Olympic Games and we're about to witness something just a little bit different. The last four events have seen four gold medals for China, with both Yang Hao and Wu Xingping cleaning up in the men's and women's 3 and 10 metre events. Now, in the mixed team events, things have been shaken up to the extent where there are no national teams. All athletes are competing with someone from another country. And I think you'll agree, a fascinating prospect with some eye-catching matchups.
Yes, this is something really quite original here, an innovation at these Youth Olympic Games, and I think it really is capturing the whole spirit here of involving all the athletes, and we could get something quite amazing. We could get athletes who really didn't expect to be on the medal podium will actually get the chance now. What they've basically done is taken the men's 10 metre and the women's 3 metre top 11 and put the number 1 from the men's platform with the number 11 from the women's 3 metres. So no international teams, and we're getting some really interesting combinations.
Quick look at our judges, who are on either side of the pool, of course.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, please keep quiet during the competition.
Well, the start lists don't really give us much of an indication there, because, as you can see, they're just divided into team numbers.
It's interesting, isn't it, that we do have, for example, the Chinese who won both golds in men's and women's, of course. Yang Hao with Veronica Lindau of Sweden, who came 11th in the 3-metre platform. And Wu Xingping with the plucky but not very successful Mohab El-Khoury of Egypt. Here are the athletes then.
Yes, it'll be interesting to see if the best combination is to have a real match winner with somebody who maybe hasn't performed at their best, or in fact to have two mid-range divers and see if they've got the big combination. Let me just run through how it's going to work. Three rounds of diving. Each diver has to do a 2.0 difficulty dive as well, from either springboard or platform. Each diver must do one of their three dives from either the springboard or the platform. We're now seeing how the combinations have been drawn up together there. Team 3, for example, has Josephine Schneider and double medalist Philippe Gagné. And a lot of these divers will be choosing their favourite dives, of course, and they can dive in any order. They can put their compulsory dive first or last, or they can put their platform first or their springboard first. Does all sound a bit confusing. I'm sure it'll clear up as it goes along, but it is going to give us something that's totally unpredictable.
Absolutely. For example, here's Ingrid de Oliveira of Brazil with Timo Bartel. Both of them have done pretty well just outside of the medal, so they might be contenders, because they'll be solid all the way through. And well, the silver medalist Noshlik with Jonathan Chan, who came 10th in the 10-metre platform. And well, the Malaysian Lo, who has a bronze and a silver, she will be looking to do well on there. Slightly mixed up actually in the order. That's why they are having a little smile, because they're being introduced in the wrong order. But you can see the idea. Mixed teams, mixed abilities, and we'll get you through it as the event unfolds. And we're hoping to see some really good diving, as we have seen, of course, in all the events in the 4 days preceding this.
One other thing, they can't just choose their favourite dives. The dives also have to be spread across the four different groups of dives, inward, outward, reverse, etc. So if you wonder why they just haven't stacked up their best dives, then that's the reason, because they have tried to get a range of diving that reflects all their skills.
And there does have to be a 1.2 degree of difficulty dive in the dives we get away. So underway we are, and team one is Veronica Lindau of Sweden on top of the 10 metre board, and Yang Hao of China we will see shortly. This a arm stand forward somersault from the 18-year-old, the Swedish national champion.
Veronica having to show that she's got the dive under control right there at the top. Remember, these divers haven't performed these dives so far in the game, so it is a new experience for them, but they will be used to them. Just a little bit of over-rotation there on the entry.
Well, not bad from the judges. 40 from her. Of course, a low degree of difficulty. Reminder, the middle three count, they are added together, multiplied by the degree of difficulty. Now, this is a man who has two goals to his name. He's getting the 2.0 degree of difficulty dive out of the way with a back dive. Off of, as you can see, the 3 metre board. We'll be alternating three dives apiece on these divers.
Well, Yang Hao was quite sensational in all his competitions. That beautiful, clean list of entry there again. So relaxed. Going to find it hard to find some faults with that.
Well, we saw lots of 10s in the 10-metre platform. And, well, he started well again, hasn't he? 53 the score for the Chinese double gold medalist with the simplest dive he'll have all day. Now we're on to team two. Alejandra Rosoco Loza. Back dive. A lot of these athletes just getting this easy dive, or relatively easy dive, out of the way on the 3 metre springboard.
Well, she was stronger on the platform than the springboard, but she's made a very tidy job of that, as you would have expected from an Olympic silver medalist.
You know, silver in the 10-metre platform, but sixth off the springboard, so she's decent at this as well.
Just a little bit of an angle on the entry there, made it not quite as tidy as she would have liked. 44 points.
Now then, Daniel Jensen, sixth in the 10-metre platform, seventh on the 3-metre springboard. So he is a very solid competitor, and he has the 2-point degree of difficulty reverse dive from the springboard.
Daniel, quite a strong, powerful diver, getting good height off the board there. Nothing too much wrong there.
Well, it's solid from both of the athletes in team two. And we move quickly on to team three with the German, Josephine Schneider, in with 2.5 somersaults. This a 2.7 degree of difficulty. Getting into that tuck position off of the 3 metre springboard. Okay.
Josephine only competed in the 3 meter event. Trying to get through the somersaults, their head a little bit backwards and coming up a little bit short. They're not really getting time to get into a good entry position, 48-60.
Well, that's not so bad. She only came 10th in the springboard competition, but she's up with Philippe Gagné from Montreal in Canada, and he has a bronze and he has a silver. Wonder if he can get the set. It's off the 10 meter. The reverse dive gained the 2 degree of difficulty.
Well, Philippe has had a great games overall, really shown that he can turn on the performances when it really matters. Very nice position there.
Yeah, solid all the way through, and that was a solid dive as well. 51 points for the Canadian. That's enough to put Team 3 into the lead at the moment. They have 99.6 points, just over 3.5 points ahead. So, here's the local superstar then, Wu Shengping. 2 golds in the 3 and the 10 meter events. She will start with the easy of the dives, the easier of the dives, the back dive. Degree of difficulty just 2.
Well, she really is just a joy to watch, isn't she? Her victory at 10 metres was even more overwhelming than her success at 3, but still, that is pretty much a textbook.
Yeah, judges like it as well. Nines and an 8.553, caught highest score at the moment, and you never guess who had the other highest score, and that was her Chinese compatriot. Now, this is who she is teamed up with, and we love Merhab Alkordi. Only competed in the 10 metre platform. He came 11th, but he really gave it a go, and now he finds himself on the 3 metre springboard at a reverse dive.
Well, we've not seen young Mohab on the springboard so far, but quite a lightweight physically diver. He's got good spring there into the pike position, just loses the shape there, just see the legs waver, and that's rather spoiled what was looking a promising dive.
Yes, 37 the score, which is the lowest so far, and interestingly that puts Team 4 into 4th place. Now on to Team 5, and Gracia Layden Mahoney, the American, 4th in the 3 metre event. But she's up on the 10-metre platform at the moment, the 18-year-old.
Well, Gracia's programme didn't really have too many big mistakes in it, so she's been quite consistent, which is always encouraging. Just reaching out to punch that hole through the water. A little bit of an angle on the entry on the legs, but no major issues.
Yes, and 42 for the American. She was 8th at the 10-meter event, so she'll be pleased with that dive, I think it's fair to say. Now her teammate from Ukraine, Pyotr Tarchenko, 8th in the 10-meter platform yesterday. He did really well in the previous event. Event that gets you into the final and gives you a score, but he fell away. Yeah, his coach liked it.
Philip's been a little bit frustrating in that he has produced some very good dives, but in the 10 metre final just seemed to trail off a bit with his concluding dives, but he'll be pleased to have made a nice clean start with that.
A decent score as well, 48. And these are good scores considering the degree of difficulty is low on these 2.0 dives. And quickly on then to team six. Still, it's the team three of Schneider and Gagne who are leading. Here's Laura Bilotta of Italy, another of the simpler dives, the forward 1.5 somersault off of the 10-meter platform.
More of a springboard diver than a platform diver, hence probably deciding to get her compulsory platform dive out of the way with one of the more straightforward ones. Not a bad pike position, just not really pulling the legs all the way through the water there.
And Mark down as a result, 39 for the Italian for that forward 1.5 somersault dive. Now her teammate from Armenia, Lev Sarvagisan. He's more of an expert on the platform, but he finds himself on the springboard, which is why this is such a fascinating competition. Simple inward dive. Simple for him. He takes a long time just to compose himself.
Lev opting for a safety first policy of going with an inward dive because the divers often feel they get more of a feel for the board of the inward rather than actually having to commit to the hurdle, the last step.
And middle of the road marks as well, 42, not bad at all. Team 6 are in 6th place. Now team 7, the Brazilian, Ingrid Oliveira. A back dive. Just the simple dives most of these athletes are going for. Get that compulsory one out of the way. It's off the springboard.
Well, Ingrid and Timo Bartel could be quite an interesting partnership because they were both pretty solid in their diving. Ingrid, again, stronger at 10 metres.
Not a bad dive there, though. Seventh and fifth in the individual events. And this man, fourth and fifth. He was so close to getting a medal. Timo Bartel. This is a forward 1.5 somersault with one twist off of the 3-metre platform on the springboard.
Good takeoff position, got right to the end of the board there where you get maximum spring, the sweet spot they looked to. Didn't have much to spare at all, which gave him a chance of getting a decent entry position.
42 for him, a total for the team of 87, and they find themselves in sixth place. Still team three leading, Schneider and Gagne, Germany and Kanya. Now Krasnolik of the Ukraine, silver medalist off of the springboard. She's going off the 10-meter platform. Again, the simpler dive of her program, forward 1.5 somersaults in the pike position.
That's a pretty tidy effort there, I would say.
Crowd certainly liked it. We've got a big crowd in here.
She's been fairly solid in her performances all the way through. I like the way she held her position there all the way through into the water.
And 50 is a decent mark as well. Difficult to get huge marks when that degree of difficulty is so low. So she'll be absolutely delighted with that. And now, Jonathan Chan, who not the strongest of divers here, 10th in the platform competition for the men. the youngster, still at school. Just 17 years of age.
Well, not a bad effort, just a little bit hurried at the top there. Not totally showing he had the arm stand under control. Trying to get a good entry position, just arcs his legs a little bit, which make it look rather more untidy.
Yeah, and the judges mark him down as a result. 39 for him, team 8 into 6th place. Now then, the Malaysian, Lo Jiayi. Bronze in the 3 metre, silver in the 10 metre. This her compulsory simple 2-point dive. This is a reverse dive off the 10 metre.
What a lovely sound on entry. She's, well, to quote a phrase, one or two people I know use about divers like her, she's a very pretty diver. That doesn't mean she's a very pretty girl, which she is, but there's such an attractiveness about the way she dives, and even when it's not spot on, it looks good. But that was pretty good all round.
Elegant. She's not hugely happy, but she should be, because she has a score of 51. That simple yet elegant dive. Now here's Alexis Jandard of France. 9th the best he managed. That was in the 10 metre platform. He was 12th off of the 3 metre springboard. And that's where we find him for the back dive. And again, another simple dive. These athletes, 3 rounds, and they'll get this simple one generally out of the way first. Mixture of coaches there as well, and they're enjoying what they see.
Yeah, not quite sure how they're all communicating, but this could be a good combination, and that's a solid start by Alexis with a very good diving partner in Team 9.
Yeah, and it puts them into second place at the moment. Good haul, 94 points still. Schneider and Gagne in the lead. So, 2 more teams to go, and here's Molly Carson of Canada. She's been not near the medals, 8th off the 3 metre board, which is where she is at the moment.
Well, Molly's had her struggles in this competition. She didn't have a great opening day. She's only 15, remember, 16 next week, so to get another chance in an event like this, it would be absolutely brilliant if she ended up on the podium. Not a bad effort at all.
38 points. And we'll have to wait and see how her teammate does. Now, this is the Colombian, in Garcia Alvarez. Now, he was close to the medal, 4th in the 10-metre platform, but he wasn't so clever on the 3-metre springboard. That's where he is for the back dive. Seen a few of those, just getting this early, easier dive out the way.
Well, 2 15-year-olds here together, so this will be very interesting as well. And Kevin is a very slim, lightweight figure there, and cuts through the water neatly by nature, but that was a little bit untidy at the end, but not too bad, 44 points.
Yeah, a total of 82, only into 9th place for them. Now, this is an interesting combination. Vivian Barth of Switzerland, 9th in the 3 metre. And she's linked up with Rodrigo Diego Lopez of Mexico, who has 2 medals. So this could be interesting. Armstand forward somersault for the Swiss woman.
A well, in an ideal world, and it's asking a lot of some of these young athletes, you really want to try and get an extra bit of push off that platform, even from the arm stand. That was a little bit more of a topple almost. And she couldn't really hold the entry position all the way through.
Yeah, and she's been marked down by the judges for that. Remember, it's difficult because, as we say, the three that count, the scores, are then multiplied by the degree of difficulty. So if it's a really difficult dive and done okay, you will get more points. Anyway, here is a Mexican, Rodrigo Diego Lopez. Silver in the springboard and a bronze in this, the 10-metre platform in the men's event.
A lot of intent in that dive, I think. You can see he's very confident. Gets a bit of extra height. Pike position very quickly. Getting his arms down. Good entry all the way through.
Yeah, 7.5 and 8. 45 is his score. And not enough to keep Team 11 out of 11th place. So, Team 3 still leading from the Germans and Canadians, Schneider and Gagné. Team 9, of course, is Lowe and Jandard. Team 1 is Lindau of Sweden and Yang Hao of China. So it's quite interesting that Wu Zhengpin not near the medals at the moment, but that may change. We have two more rounds, two dives per team per round. Great, great crowds. They really have been flocking to the diving all the way through this competition. And, of course, they love seeing their athletes, but they've been respectful and encouraging to all the others. And we're away in round two with Veronica Lindau. This one, an inward 2.5 somersault, 2.7 the degree of difficulty.
Well, things are going to change now because now we've got the varying tariffs involved in this. So Veronica has chosen a 2.7 inward dive. That was her opening dive in her individual event. And she's made a fair job of that. 54 she got in the individual competition.
Yeah, she's done better here. 58.05. We will see. The scores starting to ramp up here as long as they hit the dice properly. Of course, that's the problem. More difficult, more points on offer, bigger chance that you might get it horribly wrong. So then, Yang Hao of China. 3.4, this really quite difficult reverse. 3.5 somersault from the 10-meter platform.
Well, look at his coach. He smashed this dive right out the ground with 96 plus points. When it came to the final, a gasp from the crowd because he gets that all-round entry and comes up well short. That has put the cat among the proverbial pigeons.
40.8. Didn't really get anything above 4.5. Well, that is astonishing. He did have one bad dive in the 10-meter platform. It was that round 8 that everyone struggled with. Anyway, we move on to team number 2. Alejandro Orozco Loza of Mexico. It's a 3.2 degree of difficulty. Arm stand back double somersault with 1.5 twists.
Just a little bit heavy on entry into the water, but This was her best dive in the individual competition, so she will be confident with it. And she's made sure that she got the entry as decent as possible.
Yeah, and the highest score of the competition so far, 70.40. Again, more difficult. If you can nail it, you'll get more points. Here's the teammate then for the Mexican in the team number two, the Norwegian, Daniel Jensen. It's a forward 3.5 somersault off the springboard.
Well, again, he uses the board well to certainly get as much height as possible. A tall diver, he'll need all the space he can get. Nice, tight, pucked, tucked position, and a good job of that.
Yep, and 65.10. More difficult to get really big scores when it's a middling degree of difficulty. On to team three. We're whizzing through this competition. Josephine Schneider of Germany. Back 2.5 somersault. Only 2.8 the degree of difficulty, so she really needs to nail this one.
She only got 46 points with this dive in her final. Just a little bit more untidy on the entry, but not too bad.
Well, she's done better here, hasn't she? Sevens, 6.5. Still not setting the world on a line, it has to be said. Team three into third place. Already 70-odd points behind the Mexican and Norwegian. On to Philippe Gagné, the German's teammate, the Canadian. It's a 3.2 degree of difficulty, arms down, back, double somersault, 1.5 twists.
Well, Phillips had the look of a winner in these games with his outstanding individual performances. You can see trying to get that extra lift, pushing off the platform there. Quite a lot to get through, just ran out of room to a certain extent.
Sevens though, mostly from the judges, 67.2. And that means that team three are into second position, still lagging behind the second team. And here's the local hero, Wu Shengping, the double gold medalist. Look how much she's had to strap up those shoulders. She's coming off the 10-meter board. This will be an inward 3.5 somersault, 3.2 the degree of difficulty.
Well, the crowd as enthusiastic as you would expect. Again, she really nailed this one when it mattered in her individual competition. Don't know whether she's got it quite as spot on this time. Lovely movements through the air. Just a little bit of curve on that entry was the only thing that spoiled it.
Judges didn't mind it at all. 8s and 8s and a half, 76.8. That's enough to put them into fourth place. And here's her teammate, the inexperienced youngster Mohab Alkhoury, getting off that springboard, the forward 3.5 somersault.
Well, such a contrast in the facilities these two divers enjoy. Wu with everything you could possibly want here in China, and young Mohab, who doesn't even have an indoor pool to practice in. But he's a plucky lad, and he's had a go at that one, just a little bit ragged towards the end, but good luck to him.
and he'll be happy with that. Sixes, six and a halves, 57.35 is enough to put Team 4 into silver medal position. Well, wouldn't it be something if the Egyptian came away with a medal? On to Team 5. And we start with the United States diver, Gracia Mahoney. Not a difficult dive this, 2.8, but she'll want, as a result, to make sure it's absolutely as good as she can make it. Back 2.5 somersault.
Well, she's another diver that tends to avoid the big mistakes. She got a bronze in that 3-meter qualifier for these games way back in March, and she's made a pretty decent job of that, again showing her consistency.
Yeah, she was fourth, of course, in the individual event off the springboard, and she gets 58.8 sevens mostly for her. Team 5 is in fifth place. Let's see if he can be pushed up any further by Philip Tachenko. Coming off the 10-meter board, the Ukrainian, the teammate of the American. This is not too easy, the inward 3.5 somersault.
Well, he's shown he can produce big dives. He's just had a little bit of a problem here with sustaining his full program, but he's only got to get together three times in this innovative team event. He's a very strong diver through the air, a little heavy on the entry, but not bad.
64, that will haul Team 5 up into fourth place, 212.8 points at the moment. Remember, one more round to go after this, with both divers having a dive in the round. So to Team 6, and the woman who got fifth place in the individual event on the springboard, now attempting a reverse 2.5 somersault.
That's a fairly tidy dive again from Laura, the 18-year-old. She won a bronze medal last year at the European Junior Championships, so she has got some pedigree, and that's a pretty solid effort there.
And Messi sevens for the woman from Consenza, competing for 10 years now. And here's her teammate, Lev Sargisyan of Armenia. 3.2 the degree of difficulty. This arm stand back double somersault with 1.5 twists. 17-year-old. He likes to take his time.
The whole audience was scared to breathe when he was up there, because he was very deliberate getting into that gymnastic position, able to give himself a little bit more push off the platform, and he's capable of pulling out some really good marks, and may well have done that again here.
Yeah, it was very good, that dive. He always takes his time to come off the platform or the springboard, but look at that, 8 almost across the board, 1.9 that's been marked out, 76.8. Team 6 just outside the bronze medal place by all of 6 points. Team 7 now, and we start with the Brazilian Ingrid de Oliveira, coming off the platform now, and an arm stand back double somersault, 1.5 twists. So you can get this right, she can get some good points.
Well, she's got that very gymnastic method of getting up into our arm stand position where she comes almost as though she's getting on the beam from the side. I think there was just a little bit of a twitch at the top there when she wasn't quite certain when she wanted to trigger her movement. So I think that might have contributed to an untidy entry. So never really got the whole movement nice and slick.
Yeah, just 48 for the Brazilian. It was such an elegant start to the dive. It just didn't carry on as she hit the water, which is a bit of a shame. Now, though, is her teammate, Timo Vartau of Germany. And again, not a huge amount of difficulty on this. 3.1 for the forward 3.5 somersault. You'll need to get this absolutely right.
Again, Timo using his physique and natural power to get good elevation. The judges will like that, like his takeoff and movement through the air. And they don't seem to be too critical of the rest of it.
Yeah, 71.3, the highest score by some distance for Team 7. They're into sixth place. Now we are on to Team number 8. This is the Ukrainian, Gana Krasnolik. Back 2.5 somersault. Again, not the most difficult dive, but if you can get this absolutely right, you will score well.
Well, Gana's quite an experienced diver. She's competed at world championship level, but that was on the platform. 6.66. Just a little bit messy there with the legs coming over on the entry.
Yeah, I should be disappointed with that. 50.40 for the woman who got the silver medal in the individual competition. Teammates looking now for some points to haul her up from eighth place. And Jonathan Chan, the 17-year-old from Singapore, is on the 10-metre platform for his most difficult dive of the competition.
Well, this was his best dive by a street when it came to the individual effort. I think for Jonathan, these games have been quite a challenge. Be a little bit tighter in that pint position, but all in all, it's not too bad an effort for him.
Well, his last effort got 39 points. He's done a lot better here, sevens and six and a halves. 64 the score. And teammate up into seventh place at the moment. So to Team 9. And this is the double medalists at these games from Malaysia, Lo Zhihai. 3-point degree of difficulty.
That is a rare, untidy effort from Lo Zhihai. She's looked the part so far in this competition, and that's the first time we've seen her really get anything wrong. Didn't really get out of those spins anywhere near soon enough.
Just won 5.5, and she's been scrubbed out, of course. That is a very low mark, 39. And Team 9 need a bit of help here. From Alexis Jandar on the platform for this back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist. Struggled a bit in the platform, came ninth, but he needs to help his teammate out here a bit.
Well, only one dive went badly wrong, but the rest of his were pretty reasonably delivered. He's made a brave job of that. Good attack through the twists. That pike position was a little bit untidy, but the entry was pretty impressive.
68.8, you'll be happy with that. His team up into eighth place. Oh, we're whizzing through this, aren't we? Next up, Molly Carson of Canada. Team number 10 up on the 10-meter platform. Fairly simple dive, 2.8 in difficulty, so needs to do it well.
Well, this was her best dive in the individual competition, but it was only in the mid-40s. She would be hoping to get rather better with that effort. Had a fantastic learning experience here. That's a pretty good tucked position. But it's just, again, the entry that tends to spoil her work.
Yeah, the 15-year-old, the Pan American Junior Champion last year, 50.4. Well, not spectacular. Another Colombian, Vivian Garcia Alvarez, up on the 10-meter platform, did very well in the individual event, just outside the medals in fourth place. This one a tricky one.
Great to see Molly really getting into the spirit of things. She's possibly never even had a conversation with him before, but now they're big teammates and buddies. He's not performing his two best dives, but he's so consistent all the way across that he always trots out a pretty decent score, and that's what he's done again.
Yeah, seven and a half, just one 6.5, and he'll be happy with 68.8. So on to the last team in this second round of three, Vivian Barth of Switzerland. Back 2.5 somersault. Again, not too difficult off this springboard, so she'll need to get it right.
She must like that dive because it didn't go very well for her in the individual competition, and it's possibly gone even worse for her this time. And you can see she was nowhere near quickly enough through the somersaults, and yeah, well, the score says it all, doesn't it?
Lowest of the competition so far, but in diving you just got to dry yourself off and get on with it. So can Rodrigo Diego Lopez, the double medalist so far here, with a silver and a bronze, got the bronze in the 10-meter platform. He needs to help his teammate out here a little bit. Yeah, 15-year-old.
Well, it was a very clean-sounding the rip. Some of these divers aren't really physically powerful enough yet to give it that really big sound like a Michimura Budaya might, but it was a bit more splash than rip when it actually came to look at the waters there, and he can do better than that.
Yeah, 54, I'm afraid Team 11 still rooted at the bottom of the standings by quite some distance. But at the top, it's quite interesting. Amanda Rosaco-Lova and Daniel Jensen, Team 2, are top, but only just from Team 4, which includes Wu Shengping, of course. Team 3, not far behind either. That's Schneider and Gagne. So those are the three at the moment in the top three. Team number 6 is fourth. That's Italy and Armenia.
Well, these differentials in the degrees of difficulty. You've got to start kicking in now. There's so few points over those teams that it's very hard to predict. It's also quite a difficult competition to follow when you're just in teams 4, 5 and 6 without instantly recognizing who they are. But
I think the key is just to enjoy the dives, and the medals will sort themselves out. We will get underway in this last round. One more dive for each athlete. And Team 1, of course, going first, Veronica Lindau of Sweden.
Now, you could see that the hurdle there, which is that last step before they actually launch themselves into the air, that she hesitated on it, lost all the rhythm going into it. And then the arms are going all over the shop, and you can just see she was never really in a position to deliver that dive. Just about a completed dive.
Yeah, but not enough to get really hardly any points. And what a shame, what a way to finish the competition, 16.8. And that gives Yang Hao a bit of a mountain to climb here, the double gold medalist. And he's going for a 3.2 degree of difficulty from the 10-metre platform, so this needs to be absolutely bang on.
Well, he hit this one for 6 in the individual competition, and again, he's really launched it. Head could have been a little bit closer, but who's counting, really? That was another top draw effort. Look at that. That's as good a dive as we've seen in the competition.
Well, a 10. It is scrubbed out for the scoring, but 91.2. I'm sure Lindau will say thank you to Yang Hao. Team number one on top for the time being. It's not going to stay that way. Here is Alejandro Orozco Loza in the medal hunt, it has to be said. Needs a steady dive here and a 3.2 tariff.
Well, what makes her such a successful synchro diver, she dives with Paula Espinosa, who is a real star, is that she doesn't let her down. So without being a dazzling diver herself, no disrespect meant, she is really, really steady. And they know they're in with a chance. New partnerships are being forged.
Yes, well, the bronze medalist in the 10-metre platform has done it again. That's very solid, isn't it? 8s, 8.5s, and 7.5s. And 76.8 will do it very nicely, thank you very much. Already at the top of the pile. What can Daniel Jensen do here? 3.2, another middling degree of difficulty. Back 2.5 somersaults with 1.5 twists. Little smile from the Norwegian.
Well, he's been a busy boy. Well, they're really delighted with that. He's not got a dive wrong pretty well when it's mattered right throughout these games. And that's a great instinct to have. And he's done an excellent job on that. Good through the air, good entry, just good.
Absolutely. And that is a big gap they've opened up at the top of the leaderboard at the moment. We'll keep you in. Us how we are looking. On to Team 3. They're in with a chance as well. Josephine Schneider. Big dive for her. Simple dive. This is the 2-point degree of difficulty.
very sensibly, Josephine, who was not in the platform competition, has opted to put her compulsory 2.0 degree dive onto the platform as her designated 10-meter dive, and she's delivered that really cleanly. So that's a good bit of thinking there, and she's justified it.
Absolutely, nothing wrong with that. Look at the score of sevens. Of course, the score will be lower because of the degree of difficulty when you multiply those three scores. And you won't get as many, but you can't ask for any more than that. And then here comes Philippe Gagné, bronze and silver already. This a 3.5 degree of difficulty. Reverse 1.5 somersaults, 3.5 twists. To get this right, you're in with a chance.
This is the dive, but one in the bronze. Not this time, I don't think, though. You can see they're looking a little deflated with that. Well, he's shown a great instinct to seize the moment in these games. Committed himself through the air, but that's where it went wrong on entry, and he will be extremely frustrated.
Yeah, he will. 61.25, and Team 3 in the silver medal position at the moment. Now then, the woman of the moment, Wu Shengping, Team 4 in fourth at the moment. 3.2 the degree of difficulty. She has been outstanding so far.
She picked this dive because it was her poorest in the individual. She must have thought she was maybe giving the others a chance. Look how she works that dive, gets a little bit of push off, even though she's a very slight figure up there. And look at that, that is absolutely ramrod straight.
Well, didn't get a 10 like her compatriot earlier in this round, but nines almost all the way across. That is excellent, 86.4. for her.
Might even see her smile.
I know. Well, this man will smile if he can nail this. 3.3 degree of difficulty for our plucky Egyptian, who will give it a go. You can be sure of that.
Tell you what, he's really given that the full face of the bat. This is his coach, the professor. He really has got a lot of courage. I think the crowd really like him. 64-35.
Yeah, it's not quite enough to get them up into the gold medal position at the moment. Team 4 are in silver. To the American now, Maiden Mahoney, with a fairly straightforward reverse 2.5 somersaults.
Very nice. She saved her best dive from the final till last, and Philip, her partner, has also done the same, so this could make it very interesting. She has delivered that really well, and that's a great note for her to end these games on. Well done.
63 the points, already up into fifth with that medal at that point haul. Now this is a 3.4 degree of difficulty, so Philip Kachenko, if you pull this off, you're in with a chance of a medal.
Well, Ukraine have some strong divers on the international scene, strong in performance and strong physically, and he looks another one. Launches himself right at the end of that board to get the maximum elevation. Just a little bit untidy on the entry, but fully committed to the dive.
Yeah, not bad. It's enough to put them into third place at the moment. Well, it's very tight, this competition. Here's Team 6, who are too far away, I'd say, to be in contention. But you want to finish this competition with a good dive. And here's Laura Villotta.
Nice sounding dive on entry. Mid-50s was her scoring with this one. If she can improve on that, then she'll at least have ended on a same again, exactly the same as she did in the individual event.
Inera said they were sixth going to this round. You can see himself at the far end on the big screen.
You're entitled to enjoy it after all.
Absolutely. I'll tell you what, this is a 3.6 degree of difficulty, so he's quite relaxed with his really difficult dive, and this could put them into contention.
He's got to go soon. He's got to. Dear me. Well, he improved on his first dive, and that is an absolute eternity up there on the platform. 64.80, so the judges will have to light this higher than that. Are all the best things in life worth waiting for? Well, we'll find out from these marks.
Not bad. He does spend an age getting himself psyched up. 77.4. That puts Team 6 into fourth place. Now, here is the team that was sixth at the end of the penultimate round. Team 7, Ingrid. De Oliveira, the Brazilian. This is not a too difficult dive. 3.2 in with 3.5 somersault on the 10-meter platform.
Well, this was her poorest dive in the individual competition. She got 54 points from it. That might not be a bad score after that, because it got a bit untidy in the latter stages. Not too bad from there, but this is where the problems start and finish. And that's a little bit of a disappointing finale for her.
Yeah, 4s and 4.5s deficient in the judges' scorebook. Not a nice way to finish. There he is, Timo Bartel, to go next. A degree of difficulty. Get this right, and you can harvest the points.
Got nearly 80 points from an individual competition, but that I'm afraid went all wrong. There's quite a lot in the dive, so through the tucks, somersaults, reaching for the water, but you can see there was no time left to get his legs upright and have any sort of an entry.
35.7, that's a real disappointment. You can see the coaches. This is who we're having a sneak peek at earlier on, Ukrainian Krasnelik. Not too difficult off the springboard. He's were seventh going into the final round. The 18-year-old.
Well, again, she's gone, not surprisingly, to pick her best dive from the individual final. Very committed off the board, getting good elevation and really looking to snap into that entry position. But it still didn't end up quite as tidy as she wanted.
51.87, the best score she got, that was scrubbed through. Now, her teammate, this is Jonathan Chan of Singapore, finishing his program with a inward 2.5 somersault.
Well, Jonathan wasn't in the 3-meter competition, of course, so weren't sure what to expect from that dive. Doesn't get any huge height off the board. His pike position was okay, but came up well short in the end.
Yeah, 48 points from him. Again, not going to set the world on fire with those kind of scores from the judges. So, three more teams to go. Here's Team 9. And we're down in the rankings, despite the efforts of the double medalist, though. Yi from Malaysia.
Well, that's a bit more like it from Lo. I mean, her previous dive was quite out of character, or out of the character she's shown in these games anyway. That's not her most successful dive, but she's made a much better fist of it, and it's always good to see a positive response after a disappointment.
Much better, 58.8. Seven's the score that went forward to be added together and multiplied by a degree of difficulty. And then teammates. Must be quite a pressure to be teamed up with someone who has two medals, and you haven't got better than ninth, but he's tried his best here and done pretty well. Thanks, Jandar. And an Armstrong back double somersault, 1.5 twists.
Well, had those extra wrist supports there, had his Armstrong position pretty well under control. You can see it's a reasonable push off the platform. Just it was a little bit untidy most of the way through.
Yeah, and he's more than 10 points behind on his last dive, which is also from the platform, 57.6. Enough to push his team into sixth place. With two teams to go. Here's the, even by the Youth Olympic Games standards, the youngster, Molly Carson. She will finish with an inward 2.5 somersault off the springboard. 2.7 the degree of difficulty, so not too difficult.
Well, well done to Molly. She's the youngest diver at these games. She's had a bit of a wrestle with a few dives on the way through. She trains out in Thunder Bay, where she's from, cut off from the rest of the Canadian 15, but that's really encouraging that the 15-year-old should end her program with a clean dive there. And she's so shown that she likes to smile, and that should make sure that she smiles all the way home.
And here's her teammate, Kevin Garcia-Alvarez, with a back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twist to finish off on the platform. Such a young face, doesn't it? But look at the composure and the concentration.
Well, he produced 5 solid dives in the individual 10-meter competition. Very good piked position there. Pulled the dive all the way through the water. And reasonably consistent, and at least he's got a new friend.
And Team 10 up into 6th place. So, 2 more dives in this competition for Team 11, and Vivian Barth will finish off with a 2.4 degree of difficulty off the springboard, a forward 2.5 somersault.
That brings the whole diving competition to a close, these last team 11. Again, not really the result that you would have wanted there. And it's down to Rodrigo to wind up the whole show.
Yeah, they're not going to be challenging for medals, but there's a lot of pride and inner happiness to be gleaned from a good dive. It's a difficult one, a 3.4 inward 3.5 somersault.
The thing about Mexican divers, it seems, that they don't spare the horses when it comes to the degree of difficulties. They always put together a very ambitious program. And Rodrigo's like that for a 17-year-old. That was a 3.4, and he's done a good job of delivering it. And I think he's somebody that we're going to hear a bit more from, to say the least. They've got some very good divers in Mexico.
Absolutely, his 3.6 degree of difficulty dive didn't go so well. 78.2, they will end in 11th place, but well, it's been a hard fought battle, and it's the...
Well, Wu gets a silver for a change, and it's Orozco, Loffa and Jensen who get the gold. That's another medal for the Olympic silver medalist, but a really nice competition. I like this, the divers have all got on, and that is a great way to bring everything to a conclusion, I think. And Croatia, Leighton Mahoney as well, and Filip Takachenko, a bit of Ukrainian-American alliance.
So Team 2 have the gold medal. That's Rocco, Lotha and Jensen, Metzko and Norway. The silver to Wu Shengping to go with her 2 goals. And Mohab El-Khoury, what a lovely story. He's been struggling in the individual events. He gets that. And the bronze goes to the Americans and Ukrainians, Leighton Mahoney and Filip Takachenko.
Well, I'm sure the organisers will regard that as a success.
It's interesting, isn't it? Yang Hao, who has 2 golds, has to settle for 9th place. So this mixing up of all these teams has been fascinating, and it has given others a chance to take home a medal. I mean, Mohab El-Khoury, we love him for his absolute attack and his enthusiasm. And he was last in the individual 10-metre platform, and he has a silver here. That's fabulous, isn't it?
It's also very important, I think, for diving in Egypt, where they're trying to upgrade the facilities as much as possible. And certainly that just being able to, you know, show them an Olympic silver medal in a rather innovative event will hopefully give them a little bit more push to get the support they need and try and develop the sport out there. But I think it has been a big innovation, this. It's brought out a very significant crowd as well. So all in all, if you're talking about capturing the spirit of the games, then you can't really criticise this as an event. It's really gone extremely well. I thought we've got two more late entrants of the four out there are going to dive in, the Nanjing Lelis.
Well, they've been great fun at all the venues, it has to be said. And the crowd have certainly taken to them. And as we were saying, this mixed team event, perhaps reflecting the nature of the Youth Olympic Games more than anything, participation, friendship, making new connections. And that's really what we've had here at the Youth Olympic Games. And just a reminder, the gold here goes to the Mexican Alejandro Orozco Lotha and the Norwegian Daniel Jensen. The silver to Wu Shengping of China and Mohab El-Khoury. And the bronze goes to Gracia Layden Mahoney of the United States and Filip Tarchenko of the Ukraine.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie de Bangkok Rezegi International Mixed.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the mixed international team.
女士们、先生们，第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会混合国际团体颁奖仪式现在开始。
Voyagoyen le medaille.
Please welcome the medalist.
欢迎获奖运动员入场。
Gracias, Layden Mahoney and Philip Tachenko, United States and Ukraine, united in this team number five, who beat the Italian and the Armenian by just 5.4 points into that bronze medal position.
That's a great boost for both of them individually. Both countries with a strong diving tradition. And a great reward there, and a good good East-West alliance.
So Layden Mahoney and Tachenko take bronze. And what a lovely story this is. The double gold medalist already, Wu Shengping. Mohab El Kordi of Egypt, the man who was at the bottom of the pile when it came to the 10 metre individual event, but he has given it everything, and look at that smile.
I've just seen his coach, and the only way you could describe it is he has legged it 50 metres along the side of the pool to make sure he's right next to the TV camera, and he is going to preserve that moment forever. I mean, that is, if you want Olympic spirit, there it is in a picture.
Yes, Alejandra Zocaloza and Daniel Jensen, Mexican and Norway together. The Mexican already has a bronze, but Jensen has been close, but not close enough up to now. But top of the podium for both of them. I don't think either of them can quite believe it.
Well, Alejandra is a real team player, successful in the synchro events, and she is not the sort of diver that ever lets anybody down, but a great boost as well for Daniel Jensen and for diving in Norway.
Yeah, less than 5 points the victory margin, but it doesn't matter, they have the medal. And now, instead of a national anthem, we'll have the anthem, the Olympic anthem. We'll be right back. Well, it's not a sight or a sound you hear very often, the Olympic anthem, and of course the Olympic flag being raised in this mixed international team. Just a reminder, the bronze medal going to Layden Mahoney of the United States, Chechenko of Ukraine, the silver to Wu Chengpeng and Mohab El-Khoury, and of course the gold going to Alejandro Orozco Loza and Daniel Jensen of Mexico and Norway, respectively.
Friends for life there. Certainly won't forget that day. And also a victory for consistency in the end, because both of them are very reliable performers. And in this interesting format, that was what shone through in the end.
Well, all smiles. It's been a lovely competition and perhaps a fitting end to the diving competition here at the Youth Olympic Games.
I think they'll regard this whole diving competition overall as a success. One or two of the young competitors have found it a bit difficult, but they've had the experience and the encouragement. Whereas at the top end, we've seen some outstanding diving. And of course, China have repeated their double-double.